And here's where history comes in. The New Deal faced an economic crisis. Did it turn to private enterprise? Well, it had already seen private enterprise fail. The so-called free market failed. The private business was not solving the problem. The government created millions of jobs. The government created millions of jobs in the 1930s. They put people to work and they paid them. They even put artists and musicians and theater people to work. They put young people to work. Instead of sending young people to war, they put young people into what they called CCC camps, Civil Conservation Corps. And these young people, they built roads, and they cleaned up rivers and lakes, and they constructed playgrounds and swimming pools. And they did the New Deal was, you know, they invoke the name of Roosevelt, but they don't talk about what was done in the New Deal. The government stepped in and said, private enterprise is not going to do this. We're going to give money, jobs, directly to people. That's what we need to do in this case. We're going to need more than $700 billion because we're going to have free health care to everybody. Free health care. And they have this in other countries, and it works quite well. They have this in countries poorer than us, and it worked quite well. But we're going to need more money for this. Well, we have the money. We're spending $600 billion on the military. Whoa, there's a lot of money there. And if we decide we're not going to be a war-making nation, we don't need a $600 billion military budget. See? And there are hundreds of billions, maybe trillions of dollars, which have gravitated in the last 20 or 30 years to the upper 1% of the population. Do you know that? There's been a huge transfer of wealth from the bottom to the top. Not just, by the way, not just with the Bush administration, even with the Clinton administration. Even with the Kennedy administration, Johnson administration, the tax rate on the upper 1% got lower and lower. So there's a lot of money there if we change the tax system. And I assure you, if we change the tax system, those rich would not be poor. They just, instead of being super rich, they would just be rich, you see. And there would be a lot of money left to do all these things that need to be done.